But since it's earnings season, let's talk about a company which came out with a strong December quarter. And we're talking about Sterlite Technologies, which posted a profit of almost 83% this time around. The company's also recorded the highest order book ever that sums up to 4,573 crore rupees. To help us decode the earnings in further detail, joining us now on the phone line is the Chief Financial Officer of the company, Mr. Anupam Jindal. Mr. Jindal, good afternoon. Thanks a lot for joining us and congratulations and good set of quarter numbers this time around.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks a lot.
Mr. Jindal, looking at the numbers, it looks like the growth in the export market for you has been pretty good. Could you take us through the key highlights of the quarter?
Yeah, so driven by the global data consumption explosion, which is being seen, driven by the newer technologies like 5G coming in and overall various measures happening in the world, the fiber continues to grow globally, and Sterlite being one of the key players globally is getting the direct benefit of that through its access in European market and various other export territory. So we have seen a sustained volume coming in from our plants in both fiber and fiber cable business, giving us better efficiency, and since we are also consciously putting in efforts to expand into newer territories as well as newer customers, we are able to expand our export footprint, and this year, this quarter was the highest ever quarter in terms of export sales, crossing 500 crore from the quarterly sales perspective.
So what's the contribution of export to overall sales, and do you see it going up further if suppose you had to give a guidance here?
So in terms of absolute value, it was 500 crore, up by about 78% YOY from last year. And from revenue perspective, it was almost like 60% of quarterly revenue. So in absolute value, definitely we believe that on annual basis, the numbers will continue to increase because the larger growth is coming from outside India market. So as and when India market improves as a fiber industry, definitely we can look at some shift happening from global to India market, but I think for next few quarters, we will continue to see growth from export market.
Hmm. There has been significant capex, from Indian companies as well, at least one or two, and government also has been emphasizing, a universal digitization kind of a campaign. Has it not really benefited the demand in domestic markets? Any particular impediments that you have seen?
Yeah, I think, the overall, from India perspective, there are two markets. One is public market, where the government itself initiates fiber rollout through Bharat Netogram or some other enterprises spending money on that. And second is from private telecom operators' perspective. So I think both of these had certain challenges in the past. We are looking at both private operators as well as the government initiatives to kick off at an aggressive approach. And then maybe that will result into a faster growth of Indian fiber market, maybe in coming quarters and coming year.
Mr. Jindal, I'm just going back to your numbers. The EBITDA margins have come in at about 24.2%, and you've said the growth has come in from the overseas market. Could you give us a breakup of the margins that you garner from the overseas market and from the domestic market? And will you be able to sustain the kind of margins that you've posted this time around?
Yeah, so this time the margins are coming far better than what we have typically reported in the past, like 21-22%. And we have maintained that our margins would broadly be in that range of 21-22%. We have always committed that our growth of EBITDA will continue in absolute value. The margin percentage depends on the mix between products and the services business and how we are operating in that. So the margins are not materially different between the domestic market and export market. So that will not have a major impact on the overall percentage, like 24-25% EBITDA margin, which we gave this quarter.
Okay, and talking about the order book, you've also reported that this is the highest ever order book reported by the company. But if I go by the order book mix, orders from services and software, that's remained constant. What is your outlook there, and do you see more orders coming from this space in the near future?
Yeah, we are very confident of increasing our order book from services business as well. Somehow the services business order book remains quite bumpy, and we might have one order coming up once in a while and increasing that order book. So we continue to work. We have a strong pipeline of bidding, which we have done, and on private side also, we continue to work with multiple operators.
All right. Mr. Jindal, sorry to interrupt you. We've got HUL numbers coming in, but all the best for the coming quarters. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
Well, you've got the HUL numbers flashing there on your screen, which do look good. The net profit for the quarter has come in at about 1,330 crore, which I believe is above what the Bloomberg estimate was throwing about. That was 1,167 crore. Remember, there were a lot of tailwinds for the company this time around on the low base. There was restocking after